and welcome to Behind the Science, where we ask challenging questions directly to the scientists who are trying to solve today's toughest problems. I'm your host, Jennifer Fournier. Today, I'm on the hunt for the Holy Grail, looking to apply a standardized kit-based approach to some of the toughest proteins out there, antibody drug conjugates, or ADCs. In this episode of Behind the Science, let's look to see if this kit-based approach can whip some of the most complex proteins into shape. Hi, Erin.
What's with the outfit? You going on an archaeological dig?
No, but I have the ultimate challenge for you today. Mm-hmm. The Holy Grail in bioanalysis, the antibody drug conjugate, the hardest protein out there.
Well, let me see what we've got here. Wow, this could be impressive. Let's take a closer look.
Okay.
All right, Jen, so I see what you've got here is trastuzumab emtansine, or TDM1. So this is actually what we call a lysine-conjugated ADC. And this particular one has 90 possible sites of conjugation. That could make things difficult. Now, we typically use trypsin to digest a protein of this size, and trypsin cleaves at lysine and arginine. So what that means is that anywhere the payload or the small molecule is conjugated to a lysine, there's a potential for a miscleavage. So that's something we have to take into account with our quantitative results. The other thing that's interesting here is that this small molecule drug, and again, some folks call it a payload, is very, very hydrophobic. So any conjugated peptides that we detect are going to be significantly more hydrophobic than their unconjugated counterparts.
So I may have finally gotten you beat.
Not so fast, Jen. Let me take a look and see what we can do. Not only can we accurately and precisely quantify three different signature peptides from trastuzumab and TDM1, but we can also detect conjugated peptides that the competitive kit cannot. If you look at the data here, we easily see the miscleavage version of the FTIS peptide. Even at 50 microgram per mil, we can detect and quantify it. Considering the site occupancy at this position is very low, on the order of 2 to 5%, this is actually pretty impressive.
Is there anything this kit can't do?
Well, I gotta tell you, Jen, we've had a lot of stuff come through the lab. Simple, complicated, we're doing new applications all the time. So I guess we'll see what comes next.
Yeah, I think you should retire this and trust this.
I'd keep the hat though, it's a good look.
I don't know about you, but I am exhausted. I think we've thoroughly interrogated these ProteinWorks kits. It just goes to show that something simple and standardized doesn't mean it's weak and not useful if it's purposefully designed. Check out the links below to learn more about the work seen with the ADCs. And join us next time for another episode of Behind the Science.